Hello, my dear children. Once again, welcome to our physics class. Hope you all are fine over there. Children, in the previous sessions, we have completed our ray optics. And today, we are going to discuss another aspect of the optics, that is wave optics. So, light can be considered as ray. At the same time, it can also be considered as a wave. So, what are the characteristics of light as a wave? We are going to discuss about all those concepts in this chapter. So let's get started with today's session. So let's start with our new chapter, wave optics. As discussed in our introductory video, this chapter explains the wave nature of light and all its properties which it exhibits due to its wave nature. Based on the wave nature, how the laws of reflection of light and refraction of light can be proved. So we are going to discuss the reflection as well as refraction phenomena of light based on the wave nature of light, because till now we explained all these concepts based on the particle nature of the light, because we considered light as ray and we discussed reflection and refraction phenomena. That's why the previous chapter has got its name ray optics, because we considered light as particles and we represented light as rays there. But in this chapter, we will consider light as a wave and we will discuss the reflection and refraction phenomena of light based on wave nature of light. Okay. Now, light, is it a particle or a wave? Around 1800 and 1900, some of the scientists considered that light is a particle, and according to some, it was a wave. Okay, so according to Newton's theory, light is of a particle nature. This means light is made up of small particles, and those particles are known as corpuscles. This theory was known as corpuscular theory. Okay, so according to Newton, light has a particle nature, and he assumed light is made up of small particles which are known as corpuscles. Hence, this theory is known as corpuscular theory. So that was the belief of Newton. He proved the following phenomena by using the theory of mechanics. That means he proved reflection. Like this, consider the case of elastic collision, like in carom board. When we hit the striker, it strikes the boundary and bounces back. When the striker hits the boundary of carom board, it is same as an incident ray. So the striker hitting the boundary of carom board can be considered as incident ray of light. When it bounces back, it is the reflected ray. So the striker, when it is bounced back from the boundary, it is considered as the reflected ray. Therefore, in case of elastic collisions, angle of incidence is same as angle of reflection. So he explained or he proved reflection by considering the reflection phenomena or the bouncing back of light as an elastic collision. Whenever light is incident on a boundary, Newton considered that as an elastic collision of light with that boundary. Okay. He was able to prove the phenomenon of reflection of light by considering light of particle nature. So, here you can see the ball is bounced back as soon as it hits this wall. Okay, so this ball which is incident on the wall can be considered as an incident ray, and the ball when it is bounced back, it can be considered as the reflected ray. So here angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. He proved the reflection phenomena of light by considering light as a particle. Here light is compared to this ball or something like that. Okay. Then how did he explain the refraction phenomena? When light moves from a rarer medium to denser medium, it will bend towards the normal. You know that. And when it moves from denser to rarer, it bends away from the normal. According to Newton, when the corpuscles strike the boundary, the particles of denser medium tend to attract the corpuscles. When the particles are deep inside the medium, they will be attracted by all the other particles present in the medium. Okay, so whenever the light ray enters from rarer to denser medium, since light ray is composed of many different corpuscles, according to Newton, the particles of denser medium will attract the corpuscles. As soon as the light enters a medium, the total force acting on the corpuscles will be zero when it is fully inside the medium. And when the force is zero, it will move, or it will continue to move in a straight line. As there are attractive forces in one direction, the corpuscles get accelerated. As a result, there is increase in velocity and the particles slightly bend towards the normal. Okay, so this is the refraction phenomena. So here, this is the boundary. As soon as light ray enters from rarer to denser medium, what happens? The particles in the denser medium attract the corpuscles of this light, and once when it enters the denser medium, the total force acting on these particles will be zero, so it will continue the straight line path like this. Okay, then rectilinear motion of light. Newton assumed that there are two rooms side by side and are separated by a wall like this. Okay, if the window of first room is opens, the light will enter the room. Light won't enter the second room as both the rooms are separated by a wall. Okay, here you can see both the rooms are separated by a wall. Initially both are dark, but when the window of first room is opened, the light will enter the room and we can see everything inside the first room. But at the same time, light won't enter the second room because the second room is separated by a wall. Okay, so according to him, as light travels in a straight line, and whenever there is an obstruction in between the light, it won't pass through the wall. So that's why light could not get into the second room, because light travels in a straight line. This shows that light always travels in straight line. The particle theory was accepted, according to which light is made up of huge number of small particles known as corpuscles. Okay, so Newton's corpuscular theory was accepted due to this reasons. Newton could successfully explain the reflection and refraction phenomena based on corpuscular theory. Then what are the shortcomings of corpuscular theory? There are some drawbacks. This theory could not explain the phenomenon of refraction properly. When the corpuscles enter from rarer medium to denser medium, they get accelerated and their velocity increases. This shows the velocity of light particles in the denser medium is greater than velocity of light particles in the rarer medium. But this is wrong. The velocity of light in denser medium is less than the velocity of light in rarer medium. So this means velocity of light in denser medium is more than in the rarer medium, which is wrong. So Newton was not able to explain why the velocity of light is more in denser than in rarer medium. Then comes our Huygens, Christian Huygens. So according to Christian Huygens, light can be of wave nature. Okay, so here two rooms are separated by a door, and when the window of the first room is opened, what happens? Or when switch is on in one room, light enters in the second room through the door. That was the conclusion of Huygens, and this occurs because of the wave nature of light. In an experiment conducted by Newton and Huygens, two rooms were considered with an obstruction in the middle. Newton considered a boundary and Huygens considered a door as the obstacle between the rooms. In this experiment, light was switched on in one room. According to Newton, If light travels in straight lines, then first room will be bright and some portions of the second room will become bright and the rest of the room will be dark. But Huygens observed that the first room became bright and the light spread in the second room as well, but it was not as bright as the first room. Therefore, Huygens proposed that light might be of a wave nature. As the wavelength of light is very small, the wave nature of light cannot be seen. Light possess a wave nature, and we cannot see the wave nature of light because the wavelength of light is very small. And if light is made to pass through a very small portion, which is comparable to the wavelength of light, then the wave nature of light can be observed. So how is it possible to observe the wave nature of light? We can observe wave nature of light when the light is allowed to pass through a very small hole or through a very small opening. So in the first experiment, or here, when the window was open, light entered the room. So that opening of window is very large. So here, since the opening is very large as compared to the wavelength of the light, we cannot observe the wave nature of light. But at the same time, when the light is allowed to pass through a very small hole or a very small opening, wave nature of light can be observed. That was the observation of Christian Huygens. According to Huygens, Newton's theory was not fully correct. Therefore, he gave an idea that light is of wave nature. For example, if light is made to pass through a big window, then the light will appear as a ray and not the wave. But if the light is made to pass through a very small hole, then the wave nature can be observed. Huygens' idea was not accepted because of the following reasons. As there was no experimental proof of what Huygens proposed, so Huygens' idea was rejected just because there was not any experimental proof to support Huygens' assumptions. So there was, and also there was Newton's authority at that time. Okay, so all the people or everyone believed Newton because he was dominating at that time. And wave always needs a medium for propagation. This means light cannot propagate in vacuum, but sunlight is able to reach Earth's surface. So how is it possible? Because the property of wave is that wave requires a medium for propagation. In such a case, light cannot propagate through vacuum, but sunlight reaches the surface of Earth through the vacuum. So how is it possible? It became a big question. If we consider light as a wave, we can't answer to this question. This was a problem. So conclusion was given by Huygens based on this wave nature of light. Many other scientists came after Huygens to prove light is of wave nature. So one among them was Thomas Young. He performed very important experiment known as Young's double slit experiment, and he was able to prove the wave nature of light. We will discuss about Young's double slit experiment in our coming sessions. Then Maxwell, in 1860, he gave the Maxwell's electromagnetic theory of light, and he was able to prove there are visible light in the electromagnetic spectrum. And he supported the wave nature of light, and he also predicted the speed of light. So that was the contribution of Maxwell. He also considered light as a wave. After Maxwell, the wave nature of light was accepted and Newton's corpuscular theory was proved wrong. Around 1900, some of the scientists observed the photoelectric effect. In photoelectric effect, when the light falls on the metal surface, electrons get ejected from the metal surface. You had already studied about the photoelectric effect in the chapter Dual Nature. So Einstein explained the photoelectric effect by considering light as a particle. So particle nature of light is also right. So again there was a confusion. So what is light? Is it a particle or wave? Then at last it was concluded that light has a dual nature. Light has wave nature as well as particle nature. Light can behave either as a particle or as a wave depending upon the situations. Dual nature is also shown by electrons. When particle nature of light is considered, then the photoelectric effect, Compton effect, etc. can be considered. When wave nature of light is considered, then wave properties such as interference, diffraction, polarization, etc. are considered. And we will discuss about interference, diffraction phenomena in our coming sessions. Polarization has been deleted from your syllabus as a part of syllabus reduction. Okay.